فقال يا الله إني أشم عندك راية طيبة كأنها راية جدي رسول الله فقلت نعم إن جدك تحت الكسار فأقبل الحسن نهج الكسار وقال السلام عليك يا جده يا رسول الله وتعالى لي أن أقبل معك تحت الكسار وقال وعليك السلام يا ولدي يا سائر يا ولدي قد أجد لك فدخل معه تحت الكسار فما كانت الله ساعة وإذا بولدي الحسين قد أقبل وقال السلام عليك يا أمه فقلت عليك السلام يا ولدي ويقر دعيني وسلك فؤادي وقال لي يا أمه إني أشم عندك راية طيبة كأنها راية جدي رسول الله فقلت نعم إن جدك وقاك تحت الكساء فدعني الحسين نهب الكساء وقال السلام عليك يا جده يا السلام عليك يا من أختار الله فأذنني أن أدخل معكم تحت الكساء فقال عليك السلام يا ولدي ويا شافع أمتي قد أذنت لك فدخل معهما تحت الكساء فأقبل عند ذلك أبو الحسن علي بن أبي طالب وقال السلام عليك يا بنت رسول الله فقلت عليك السلام يا أبو الحسن يا أمير المؤمنين فقال يا فاطمة إني أشم عندك راية طيبة كأنها راية طيبة ابن عمي رسول الله قلت نعم ها هو ولديك تحت الكساء فأقبل علي نهر الكساء وقال السلام عليك يا رسول الله تعالي أن أكون معكم تحت الكساء قال له عليك السلام يا أخي يا وسيم وخليفتي وسائر لوائي قد أزدت لك فدخل علي تحت الكساء ثم اتيت له الكساء قلت السلام عليك يا فتى يا رسول الله اتذرني ان اكون معكم تحت الكساء وقال السلام عليك يا بنتي وبدتي وقد اتيت لك فدخلت تحت الكساء فلما امرنا جميعا تحت الكساء قدر ابي رسول الله ذكر في الكساء وامي بيدي المؤمنين الى السماء قال اللهم انا وحاجتي وعمتي لهم دمي ويعلم ما يعلمهم ويعلمني ما يعلمهم انا عرب لمن عربهم وسلم لمن سالهم وحزن لمن عادهم وحب لمن احبهم انهم مني وانا منهم فاجعل صلواتك وبركاتك ورحمتك وعفوك وبارك علي وعليهم واجمعهم عشت وتحسرهم كثيرا. فقال الله عز وجل يا ملائكتي ويا سكان سماواتي لما خلقت سماء مبنيا ولا عهدا مبنيا ولا قمرا منيرا ولا شمسا منيرا ولا خلقا سبحانا يدوب ولا بحرا يجري ولا فلكا تسري الا في محبه هؤلاء الخلقه الذين هم تحت الكساء. فقال الامير جبرائيل يا ربي ومن تحت الكساء. فقال الله عز وجل اللهم اجبرت المنظور يومها لرسالتهم فاتمتهم وبنوها اللهم فقال جبرائيل يا ربي اتعذرني انا هبت ايهبت الى الله الا اكون معهم سادسا فقال الله نعم انا قلت لك هبت الامير جبرائيل قال السلام عليك يا رسول الله الوحي والعلا وليقرك السلام ويقصك ويقصك بالتهية والإكراء ويقول لك وعزتي وجلالي اني ما خلقت السماء مبنية ولا عادا مبنية ولا عظما منيرا ولا شمسا مذيئا ولا فرقا يزول ولا بحرا يزيد ولا فلكا تسري الا لاجلكم ومحبتكم قد اذن لي ان اشكر معكم فهل تعذرني يا رسول الله. فقال رسول الله عليك السلام يا امين وحي الله انه نعم قد اذن لك. فدخل لله ما نتعلم الكفاية فقال لأبي أن إن الله قد أوحى إليكم يقولوا إنما يريد الله عليكم أن يرد على البيت وتحفكم تكفيرا فقال علي النبي يا رسول الله يأخذني ما أجلس جلوسنا هذا تحت الفقار من الفضل إن الله فقال النبي والذي بعثني بحق نبيا واستفاني رسالة نجيم ما ذكر قبرنا في محفل من محفل عن الإنعار فيه جميع من شيخنا ومجدنا إلا ونزل عليهم الرحمة وعفت بهم الملائم واستفر لهم إلى أن يتفرقوا فقال علي النبي والله يفرنا وفعل سيدنا رب الكعبة فقال أبي رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله ثاني يا أبي والنبي بارك في الحق نبي رحمن من رسالة الأجل ذكر قبرنا وعلى في مثل من مات لأن الآن فيه جميع من سيدنا ومسلمين وفيه مهموم من الله وفرج الله وحمه فلا مهموم من الله وكشف الله وغمه فلا ظالم عاجة لله وقد الله حاجته فقال علي بن عمر الله يفضله فإنه كذلك الشهيد وقال قادم وفضل الدنيا والآخرة اللهم صل على محمد وعلى
محمد
آپ سب سے گزارش ہے کہ ایک سورہ فاتحہ اور تین سورہ اخلاص پڑھ کر مرحومین اپنے بزرگان بالخصوص علماء دین اور مجتہد دین براج دین جو انتخاب کر کے ان کے لیے بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم الحمد للہ
محمد وعلى محمد صلى
الله عليه وسلم
محمد وعلى محمد
بری خلق میں ان آنکھوں نے کیا کیا
ایک گھٹری
شہدی پشت پہ لائے اس میں نے ٹکڑے ہوئے قاسم کا سراپا دیکھا مجرئی خلق میں ہائے کیوں ہو نہ گئی کور کے ان آنکھوں نے ہائے کیوں ہو نہ گئی کور کے ان آنکھوں نے قید خانے میں سکینہ کا جنازہ دیکھا مجرئی خلق میں جا کے زینب نے مدینے میں کہا صغرہ سے جا کے زینب نے مدینے میں کہا صغرہ سے کم کس منہ سے کے پر دیس میں کیا کیا دیکھا مجرئی خلق میں ظلم ہے مجرئی سجاد نے کیا کیا دیکھا ظلم ہے مجرئی سجاد نے کیا کیا دیکھا گھر لٹا قید ہوئے باپ کا لاشا دیکھا مجرئی خلق میں ان آنکھوں نے کیا کیا دیکھا پر کہیں صدق پیغمبر برسانا آقا دیکھا مجرئی خلق میں
صلوا عبد محمد وعلى الله جب محفل یزید میں داخل حرم ہوئے آیا ہر قدم پہ یہ ظلم و ستم ہوئے زینب پکاری حادثے سے بھی کم ہوئے سر کٹ گیا حسین کا سر ننگ ہم سر کٹ گیا حسین کا سر ننگ ہم پر کیوں آسمان گر نہیں پڑتا دہائی ہے زہرا کی بیٹی سامنے حاکم کیا زہرا کی بیٹی سامنے حاکم کیا موجود انجمن میں صغیر و کبیر ہے حاکم کے گرد کرسیوں پر سب امیر ہے خاصان زلزلہ ذلیل و حقیر ہے مشکل کشا کے خود کلاس و بصیر ارے کیسے کوئی علی سے یہ دار السلام میں زینب کا داخلہ ہوا دربار زینب کا داخلہ ہوا دربار اے لوگ کربلا سے میرے بھائی کو بلاؤ اے لوگ میرے گیسو والے دو اے لوگ میرا حادثہ سنا اے لوگ یادگار حسن سے کہو کیا قاسم سے ہائے کچھ نہ کمک اس گھڑی ہوئی یہ بات ہونے کس کی دلن ہے گھڑی یہ بات ہونے کس کی دلن ہے گھڑی ہو کر اسیر دختر حاتم جو آئی تھی نانا نے میرے خود سے چادر اڑائی پوشاک اما نے نہیں اس کو کنائی تھی سب کو یہ پاس تھا کہ سخی کی وجہ ارے امت کو آئے پاس رسول خدا نہیں زینب رہنا سر ان کو آیا زینب رہنا سر ان کو آیا بابا کو میرے پوچھو تو کیسا سخی ہے وہ مشکل کشا ہے کل کا خدا کا ولی ہے وہ نانا کو میرے دیکھو تو سب کا ولی ہے وہ بھائی کے صدقے فقر نبی وہ علی ہے وہ ارے میری خبر اسیری میں لیتا نہیں کوئی کپڑا بھی منہ چھپانے کو دیتا نہیں کپڑا بھی منہ چھپانے کو دیتا نہیں کوئی دربار میں یزید کے ہر سو تھا اشدام تھرا رہے تھے بیت کے مانندی خاصم بیٹھا تھا تخت نحس و نطفہ حرام ایک ہاتھ میں تو شیشہ تھا ایک ہاتھ میں تھا جام بالائے تخت شغل تھا اس کو شراب کا اور زیر تخت سر خلق بوترا اور زیر تخت سر خلق بوترا حاضر وہاں تھا ایک فرنگی بھی اس گھڑی رو کر کہا یزید نے اس یزید سے اس نے کیا اے شقی تیرے معاملے سے نرستا ہے میرا جی رہے طبق میں جس کا یہ مجرم ہے کیا کوئی حاشا جو میں کہوں کہ یہ اہل قصور ہے زلفوں میں بوئے مشک ہے مہرے بچوں زلفوں پہ بوئے مشک ہے چہرے پہ زلفوں پہ بوئے مشک ہے چہرے پہ نور ہے جاتا ہوں شاہد ان کی خدمت میں آنکھ جب وہ مجھ سے پوچھتا ہے وقائے یہاں کے سب پر آج ماجرا نظر آتا ہے کچھ عجب امید وازوں کے مفصل سنا تو اب مسکن تھا اس قتیل کا کس سر زمین پر تھا دین پر کے محمد کے لیے تھا دین پر کے محمد کے لیے زنجیر پہلے کانپتا ہے یہ جو نو سوال کیا نام اس مریض کا ہے جلد کر بیان یہ ننی لڑکی جس کے گلے میں ہے ریس ماں اس کا تو وہ ہے سن کے ہو کافر بھی مہربان رانوں سے انتقام تو لیتا ہے حیف ہے آزار ننے بچوں کو دیتا ہے آزار ننے بچوں کو دیتا ہے حیف ہے تیرے معاملے سے میرا ہو جاتا ہے کیا ہر بات تجھے کٹا سر سناتا ہے جو چوب بیت اس کے لبوں پر لگاتا ہے کوئی بھی ہاتھ مرد کے سر پر اٹھاتا ہے اس کا گناہ تو مجھے حیران کر گیا باقی قصاص رہ گیا سر اتر باقی قصاص رہ گیا سر اتر گیا مزہ کہ اس کی جنگ ہوئی یا کہ ملک پر کیا منحرف تھا قبلہ سے لوٹا جو اس کا گھر کیا تارک سلا تھا کاٹا جرس کسر سر زینب سے ضبط ہو نہ سکا بولی پیٹ کر حق پر موا ہے فرقے باطل سے پوچھ لے سجدے میں سر کٹائے تو قاتل سے رو سجدے میں سر کٹائے تو قاتل سے رو یہ سن کے اور کانپنے لگ کانپے فرنگی کے دست پا کہنے لگا یدی سے تو نے نہ کچھ کہا پوچھے جو شاہ روم کے ان سے کروں میں عرض کیا یہ کس کا سر ہے نام بتا اور نسب بتا بولا شقی کے بند کرو شور شین کو کر دیجیو یزید نے مارا حسین کر دیجیو یزید نے مارا حسین اس نے کہا جو کل کا ہے سلطان وہ حسین نانا کو جس کے آیا ہے قرآن وہ حسین جس کے پدر کے سب پہ ہے احسان وہ حسین ماں جس کی فاطمہ ہے میں قربان وہ حسین جس پر نبی نے اپنے پسر کو فدا کیا خالق نے جس کو بچایا ہوا تھا خالق نے جس کو بچایا ہوا تھا حاکم نے سر ہلا کے کہا ہاں وہی حسین منہ پی کر پکارا فرنگی بشور حسین غارت کرے شتاب تجھے رب مشرقین سرکار کر حسین کا کھویا علی کا چین اے نشان کیوں یہی مذہب تمہارا ہے نانا کا کلمہ پڑھ کے نماز ہے تمہارا نانا کا کلمہ پڑھ کے نماز ہے تمہارا ظالم پکارا جلد سر اس کا کرو جدا رسوا کرے گا روم میں مجھ کو یہی جا بجا شیران جست کر کے فرنگی نے دی ندا رسوا خدا کرے گا میں رسوا کروں گا کیا سید کا خون کر کے کہاں چھپ کے جائے گا میں شہر میں فاطمہ سے کہاں منہ چھپا میں شہر میں فاطمہ سے کہاں منہ چھپا پھر دوڑ کر حسین کے سر کو اٹھا لیا اور کلمہ پڑھ کے سینے سے اپنے لگا لیا جلاد نے کمر سے وہیں نیچا لیا اب کا اختیار نہ تھا سر جھکا آیا کسی کو پاس نہ اس بے گناہ کا تن پر سے پھر سے کر دیا وہ خارش کا تن پر سے پھر سے کر دیا وہ خارش کا اللہ
ممن چند اعلانات قبلہ مولانا رضا پاشا صاحب کی مجلسوں کے سلسلے کی کل آخری مجلس ہے یہ مجلس حضرت معمول نماز مغربین کے فوراً بعد شروع ہو جائے گی آپ تمام ممنین سے اس میں وقت کی پابندی کے ساتھ شرکت کی صدا ہے نیکسٹ ویک وینسڈے سے مولانا اسد یاور صاحب کی مجلسوں کا سلسلہ اس سزا خانے میں شروع ہوگا یہ مجلسیں بدھ جمعرات جمعہ اور ہفتہ چار دن ہوں گی یہ مجلسیں بھی بعد نماز مغربین ہوں گی ان مجلسوں میں تبرک کے اسپانسر کے لیے کچھ ڈیٹس اوپن ہیں جو صاحب بھی مجلسوں میں تبرک دینا چاہیں یہاں پہ ممبر کے پاس لسٹ لگا دی گئی ہے اپنا نام اور فون نمبر لکھ کے معصوم انتظامیہ کے کسی ممبر یا محمود دھانجی صاحب کو نوٹیفائی کرا دیں. مدرسہ معصوم کی طرف سے نیکسٹ ویک سے سٹرڈے کو شام میں مغرب کے بعد جس وقت یہاں مجلس ہوتی ہے نیچے ٹیچنگز کی کلاسز ہوں گی. پیرنٹس سے ریکویسٹ ہے کہ اپنے بچوں کو نیچے ٹیچنگز کی کلاسز میں لا سکتے ہیں. آخری اعلان یہ لیڈیز کے لیے ہے. 28 اپریل کو جو کہ ہفتے کا دن ہے دوپہر کے 12 بجے اس اذا خانے میں نیچے جو لیڈیز کا اذا خانہ ہے لیڈیز کی مجلس ہوگی. یہ مجلس خالہ جان کی طرف سے ہے. ان کی تمام لیڈیز سے درخواست ہے کہ اس مجلس سے زیادہ تعداد میں شرکت کریں. بعد ختم مجلس تابوت جناب سکینہ برآمد ہوگا. تمام لیڈیز سے درخواست ہے کہ اس مجلس میں زیادہ سے زیادہ تعداد میں شرکت کریں. اعلان ایک مرتبہ پھر سماعت فرما لیں. نیکسٹ سنڈے کو سٹرڈے کو جو کہ 28 اپریل ہے دوپہر کو 12 بجے زنانی مجلس ہوگی اس اذا خانے میں. خالہ جان کی طرف سے ریکویسٹ ہے تمام خواتین سے کہ اس مجلس میں زیادہ سے زیادہ تعداد میں شرکت کریں. صلوات بر محمد و آل محمد.
سورہ فاتحہ برائے اشار ثواب مرحوم سید اخلاق حسین ابن مرحوم سید رسالت حسین پڑھی. خواہش کی جاتی ہے کہ ایک ہمارے مومن سید ہاشم زیدی ایک حادثے میں زخمی ہو گئے ہیں, تو دعا کیجیے توجہ کر رہے واسطہ بیمار کربلا کا ان کو شفا کھلیت. اور ہمارا ایک لڑکا جس کا نام کاظم ہے اور وہ بھی علی ہے, تو واسطہ شہزاد علی اصغر کا خدا ہم شفا کھلیت. سورہ فاتحہ قلوبنا ابو القاسم محمد واهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين المظلومين المنتجبين. لعنة الله على اعدائهم وغوص بحقوقهم اجمعين. من يومنا هذا إلى يوم الدين أما بعد قال أمير المؤمنين علي بن أبي طالب إلهي ما أبدتك خوفا من نارك ولا طمعا في جنتك ولكن وجدتك أهلا للعبادة فأبدتك صلوات These are the words of our first Imam, Ali ibn Abi Talib. He has set an example as what should be considered as worship and ibadat. Ibadat of Allah is in the nature of mankind. A man can deny the existence of Allah. We may call him an atheist, but still it is in his nature that he believes in his creator, because Allah has made us like this. That power, that force, which you cannot imagine out of the realms of imagination, where we hope to get help from at the time of sorrow and difficulties and danger. He may not believe in Allah, he may not believe in God, but still that power that is kept in his nature. So with this, the ideology of worship. There were times, because of the ignorance prevailing, they used to worship the plants, man worshipping plants, man worshipping the sun, thinking, ah, this is more powerful than me. Man worshipping the moon, man worshipping other creation. That was because of lack of understanding. His mind has not grown. But still, that concept of worship was there. And it grew. They started worshipping idols. But still, the concept of worship is there. Right or wrong is a different thing, but the concept is there. And as the time grew, as you all are aware, there were 1,24,000 prophets sent to uplift mankind from its deep ignorance to the high, lofty ideals of Islam. So what happened? All these prophets were sent throughout the world and to uplift and guide humanity. We don't know the names of all, but still guidance was sent to each and every place. Even now when, for example, in a place like Singapore, can you imagine a son of Imam Reza is there buried? His name is Habib Noor. And it was passing through a highway. And you know, it's an atheist government, they don't believe in all this. While passing through a highway, it was coming very close. See, they wanted to destroy this. They got the Chinese, Singapore is full of Chinese, and they said, remove this, break this open. Those who went and tampered with this immediately died. So after losing 10 to 15 people, they left it. It is still there, Habib Noor. When you go and read the Ziyarat, it is written he is the son of Imam Reza, from descendant of Imam Reza. That means descendant of Ali ibn Abi Talib. So, can you imagine in a place like that also, guidance is there. But let me tell you here, there is a big graveyard there. It was by the graveyard belonging to the Muslims. It was in the city. They closed it about 50 years back. Now they gave it for making that as a place for flats. And they wanted to destroy the graves. And they called for tenders. No Chinese offered, no Muslims offer, the president of the Wahhabi Zia offered. He said, give me $8 a grave and do this. Chinese didn't offer themselves. Neither the Shafi, no one else. But the Wahhabi said, per grave, give me $6 to $8 and do. He was the president. As soon as he took the first installment, he was laid down with cancer and is no more. Alhamdulillah. So, what I want to point you out is this. There is guidance and there is the devil also, both going together. And this concept of ibadat as it is, was further improved and improved till Ali ibn Abi Talib laid down that which is called the rules for the achievement of real ibadah. Ilahi ma abadtuka khawfan min narik. It was the night when the world was asleep. When the creation of Allah were asleep. And in that darkness of night, a person got up. He went walking slowly towards the house of God, Kaaba. He saw, he looked at the left, he looked at the right. There were none, all were asleep. It was complete darkness and nothing could be heard. He caught hold of the wall of the Kaaba. Started weeping. Ilahi ma abadtuka khawfan min narik. Oh my Allah, oh my God, oh my Creator, I do not worship thee that I am afraid of your fire of hell. Wala o ilahi ma abadtuka khawfan min narik. Wala tam'an fi jannatik. Oh my Allah, I do not worship thee that I am in greed with your Jannah. Balakin wajadtuka ahlan lil-ibadati fa'abadtuka. Oh my Allah, I worship thee because worship is only for you and none else. This is the standard of ibadah. Prophets came and the prophets went. Their wasis came and the wasis went. People came and the so-called holy people went. But no one presented a standard of what ibadat is, as Ali ibn Abi Talib did. Understand? It's only Ali ibn Abi Talib who made the standard. I worship thee. And what was the time when the creation of Allah was asleep? Just imagine. Walking towards those days, there were no lights, nothing, darkness. Going towards Kaaba, found no one. Then he bursted out. He and his Allah, he and his Creator, he and his Maker started weeping and cried, oh my Allah, now I am bursting out. What is in my heart? Oh Allah, what is in my heart is this? That I worship thee, not that I am afraid of the fire of hell. I worship thee, not that I have the greed and dread for that which is called Jannat. But O Allah, I worship thee, you are the only one fit to be worshipped. Can the world produce this standard of worship? This was the right of Ali. And here we are the fortunate ones to believe in that. And this, we go forward. This question of ibadat, my friend, is not that we only say our namaz, our roza, and all such things. You leaving your house and coming to this place for the sake of Hussein, that is the greatest form of ibadat. Anything you do to please Allah. You are passing on the road, you find someone coming to your center and you know he or she is going for the madras. You say, well, I'll give you a drop. That is ibadah. You find an old person lifting a weight and that old person finds it difficult to lift the weight. So you stop and say, I'll help you in this. That is ibadah. small things. Not that you give millions of dollars and hundreds and thousands of dollars and do all things with show and pomp and glory that is counted for ibadat. It is that which comes out from your heart and that which you do to please Allah, only Allah, none else but Allah. That is only ibadat. Otherwise, this throne of the face, Allah is not hard up of us. You think Allah is hard up of a namaz? It is for namaz is for our own sake. To make you pure, that's all. Allah is not hard up of this namaz, nor the fasting, nor the hajj. Whatever ibadat we have and whatever halal and haram we have, all this is to uplift us. Allah does not gain anything by this. And we take out hooks, don't think you are doing a favor to Ahlul Bayt. If they accept that, they are doing you a favor. Millions of animals are cut. But those which are sacrificed in the way of Allah, they are the chosen ones, even in the case of animals. Millions of dollars are spent, but those dollars which are spent in the way of Allah for this Azadariya Hussain, that is the real money which you strive for, which you long for, because only halal will come in this way. A person who has got wealth full of haram, he will not be guided, it will not come in his way. Think of those who have millions of dollars, but they could not make it to the grave of Hussain. Think of those who have had lot of wealth, they could not go to Karbala. Why? No guidance. Money is not the problem. It is the heart which is the problem. Money is never a problem. It is your will and determination and the burning of this heart, burning, melting of this heart for the sake of Hussain. That is the problem if you lack. Understand? Recently they were showing the Chinese way of medicine by just putting the hands on the patient, heat is produced. This is a modern way into what they do in China. Now you see, by the practice, by doing this, he produces heat. And when he puts his hand on a piece of paper, that paper catches fire. So it's a scientific thing. And then heat is produced. And he is normal. Sometimes we think, isn't it? When we say, Imam Zamana will come. And he will take revenge. The blood of Imam Hussain. It comes in our minds. We are human beings. With all the hydrogen bombs and nuclear bombs and this bomb and that bomb, where can the Imam take his sword and fight? It must be coming into our minds. But you know what laser beam is, isn't it? And that laser beam, what destruction and havoc it can play, sitting in one place. And now the practice of the hand by which heat is produced. Now suppose the Imam just points, and from the Imam who has got the control of the full universe at his command, if he just makes a sign, what is the strength of the laser which will be produced? Do you think they need hydrogen bombs and atom bombs and nuclear bombs and biological weapons for all this? It's too small. To us, these are great things. But for the representative of Allah, it is negligible, too small. When we hear the greatness of our Imam, it strikes our mind, this is all too small. So we are how fortunate. How fortunate we have got our Imams like this. Why are we fortunate? Because we believe in those who are impeccable. That's it. The whole conflict between the bad and the good is, the evil and the good is, they do not want he who is a masoom. They do not want he who is an impeccable. They want someone like us. My friends,
that I have came, and I have Bashar al-Mislukum for what, you know? To safeguard Tawheed. And these idiots, they finished off the Nabuwwat itself. You know how? What were the Jews, Yahudis talking about their prophet? Ibnullah. What did the Christians talk about their leader? Ibnullah. Jesus, even today they say, no? To prove that, although it is wrong, they spend millions of dollars to prove. He is the son of God. He is the son of God. He is the son of God. And these good for nothing, they spend millions of dollars to prove Rasulullah is just like us. Can you imagine the wrath of Allah on these people? What was it meant for? When the prophet of the Jews and the prophet of the Christians were referred to as the son of God, and when Allah sent Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the idea was Muhammad did all the miracles. He had everything. He used to lift the sand and bed, he gave the witness that Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. And imagine the moon being made in two and so on and so forth, all the miracles. So it was taught, it is better to safeguard this personality. For doing small things, after all, Jesus and the others were all small prophets. For them it is, if we refer that to as Ibnullah, son of God, what will they think about the miracles presented by Muhammad? So to safeguard the Tawheed, my brothers, to safeguard the Tawheed, to safeguard La ilaha illallah, this ayat came, Ana basharun mislukum, tell them I am like you. Although I am doing all the miracles, I can do whatever I want. I can order the plants to move. I can order the moon can be made into two. I can order the sun, it will come back to the different form. I can do whatever I like. So, I am still like you. Don't think I am more. In the sense, don't call me. Had this ayat not come, they would have called him Allah. If I come there, of course, then turn into Muslims. Had this ayat not come, they would have referred to him as Allah. Just like had Imam Hussein gone to India, what will the Hindus treat him as? The Bhagwan, isn't it? Now the fight is different. Then the fight will be between us and the Hindus. They calling him Allah, we calling him Imam. That would have been the fight. Isn't it? They would definitely say, he's a Bhagwan. So my friends, this ayat was revealed, Ana basharun mislukum, to safeguard the Tawheed of Allah. And these fellows, the so-called Muslims, you can never understand that they are Muslims. Those fellows said, his elder brothers are younger brothers. Okay, he said, Ana basharun mislukum, I am like you. But did he say, you are like me? He said, "Main tum jaisa, main tum jaisa." Kabhi Rasul ne kaha, "Tum mujh jaise?" There is the whole point. Islamic history or any history, Wahhabi history, any history, no one can say, Rasulullah said, "You are like me." Koi nahi bata sakta ki Rasul ne farmaya. Tum mujhe se. And he said, tum mujhe se, except Ali ibn Abi Talib. He said that use that sentence for no one. Except Ali ibn Abi Talib, Rasulullah did not use this sentence for anyone. That is why what I explained to you last night about Surah Barat is this. You go. Call him back. Call Abu Bakr back. He can't give this information to them. You go. Or he who is like you go. And I'm Bashar Mislukum, where is it now? So my friends, the Christians are spending their amounts, the Jews are spending their wealth to propagate this wrong notion that their prophet is the son of God. And woe to these Muslims who are spending their wealth, getting the coffers emptied to prove he's an elder brother and we are younger brothers. Can you imagine? Are they not better than us? Are they not better than us? Now, at this point of time, I would like to elaborate. And that is what? Not that I am trying to tell you or create a friction between us and the other nationalities and religions like the Jews and the Christians, but facts are facts. You see, when I was leading a madrasa in the UK, I was told, don't mention the names of those three. I said, why? Because there will be friction. I said, close down this madrasa, is finished once forever. Tomorrow you said, don't mention the name of Yazid. Tomorrow you said, don't mention the name of Shubar. Because that will also hurt the feelings of some. In Libya, you find many of these people. In Algeria, you find these. So don't mention the name. No, it will bring rift. How will it bring rift? We are quoting their books and we are just presenting history. Brothers, it is impossible. Unity means what? Not that you merge with them or they merge with you, which is impossible. Especially for the Shia world. Especially for those who are the followers of Ahlul Bayt. For those who are the followers of Fatima Zahra. It is impossible to merge. How can you forget the door of Fatima Zahra being burnt? Come on, compromise? Is there anyone worth the name of calling himself a Shia, says, all right, I'll forget this? Has anyone got the guts to say that? How can we ever say this Fatima Zahra yelling out, this is the house of the Prophet, let it be. The children of the Prophet Hassan and Hussain are there, let it be, I'll burn the house. He set the house on fire, the house burnt, and Fatima Zahra was between the wall and the door, and Mohsen was in her room. The child died, and she yelled out, Subhat alayya masahibun law annaha. Subhat alayya misanna liyaliya. Forget? Let me see if we can laugh for 1 minute without this. 1 minute, 1 second, can you laugh without this? And what did he shake hands for? It is impossible, my brothers, it is impossible. So what? How does the unity come? Unity is, you are what you are, you are what you are, but in the front of those who are enemies, we say we are Muslims. That's only unity. Except this, there's no other unity. We present ourselves as Muslims in front of those who are the enemies of Islam. There is no compromise between our ideologies and your ideologies because it is impossible. Neither in this world nor in the next, impossible. How can you forget that Ali, who was the great of the greatest, unparalleled of the unparalleled, can you imagine he being chained and just pulled out? Forget. Let me see who forgets. These are the funds, had they not done this, Yazid would not have the guts to do that which he did in Karbala. Understand? It is easy to sit and talk and say, let us move towards unity. Unity at what cost? Unity at what cost? I'm not trying to say we don't mix with them. We mix with them. We have to live with them. But we know our limitations. That's all. You are known to us, we are known to you. But to us, everyone is Fatima Zahra. There are people who feel so shy to call themselves Shias. Brothers, at least be proud to call yourself Shias. How many of us, I think there will be exceptions, who do not feel proud to call themselves Shias? How many of us are there who don't feel proud to do matam on the road thinking people are watching? On the day of Ashura, How many of us behave in that way? I'm talking about India, I don't know what is here. With shoes on and with the cap on the head on the day of Ashura. Why? I'm an officer, I'm in the government. What will the Hindus think? What will the others think? If I have to preserve my dignity at the cost of Fatima Zahra. You know what actually it means? It means you have already sold out. Understand? You have already gone. Those who have such ideologies, they are already gone. You know what Pule Sirat is, isn't it? You are Jahannam. You have to go, just cross it and go. Now those who are dying there, laying down there, are those who are the enemies of Ahlul Bayt. Suppose you know them. And in this world, we will think of satisfying them. Okay, we don't do matam, we don't do this, we don't do azadari, we don't feel, we feel safe to call ourselves Shias. And you thought of his welfare. He'll be hurt if I say I'm a Shia. When you are passing that police rat and he's there, he yells out, my friend, come down. Are you prepared to go down? And in this world you were with me, you were hiding your face. You were not holding madalises in your house because your sofa set will become bad. You were trying to hide your face. You did not do matam. Why? To please me. You took care of my feelings. Now, don't leave me and go. Come down. You say, no, this is Jannat. I have to go. And there Fatima Zahra's wife will come. You come, we don't accept you. Now we reject you. You forgot my son then, now you want to my son now, we reject you. So for your own safety, be proud to call yourself a Shia and act as a Shia. What is the difference between them and us? The difference is azadari, nothing else. The difference between them, the so-called Ummah of Rasulullah. Rasulullah said, 73 sets, 72 will go. And only one will go to Jannah. And each one of them, you know how they proclaim? All of them, irrespective, all 73 believe in this hadith. They don't prove that they are going to this Jannah. What they prove is, he will not go, he will not go, he will not go. And they prove you are going. No, he will not go, he will not go. Shafi'i will say, Hanbali will not go, Maliki will not go, he will not go. And what about you? Oh, but he will not go. Except we who say, it belongs to our Allah. And we are not bothered whether we go there or not. We go and cling to the feet of our Allah, that is our Jannat. Understand? To us, Jannat is no attraction, my friends. And you know what is the meaning of the hadith which I just now read? إلهي ما بتك خوفا من نارك ولا تمن في جنتك ولكن وجدتك أهدا للعبادة فعبدتك. My friend, when you read namaz, what is the end? Jannah, isn't it? Ask a Muslim, what do you read namaz? Are we have to get Jannah. What do you fast? Are the end is the Jannah. Why do you go to hell? Besides the title, Jannat. Why do you take out zakat? Jannat. So for every action, what they think of is Jannat. Ask these boys. They are not yet grown up, isn't it? Ask why they do matam. Just see if they say for Jannat. None of us think that we are doing matam for Jannat. We do matam, oh Hussain, have we been in Karbala? We would sacrifice ourselves. That is our Jannat. Ask these youngsters, they will tell you, what is Jannat? That is irrelevant. It will come to us. It will come to us. If it doesn't come to us, where will it go? Now you analyze. Suppose it is, to analyze this, now I am also getting into the mood because I thought I wanted to read something else. Because of the crowd, I pulled myself. Now again, it's the member who makes you read. Now this Jannat, Jannat, Jannat. The so-called people whose belief is, they quote a hadith. And what's the hadith? The length of the beard is proportional to the wisdom. My God. You go to their seminars, ishtema, they say, no? Two subjects. Dari mat mundao, haram hai, namaz paro. Iske siwa, nothing you have here. Speakers after speakers, from Saudi, from the Middle East, from everywhere, from local, from Joban, whatever place you call, except Dari and Namaz, nothing else. And they quote a hadith. The wisdom is proportional to the length of your beard. How nice the Jews will be enjoying this. How nice the Christians will be enjoying this. This is the wisdom which the Muslims have. This is the wisdom. Inshallah, I'll elaborate this tomorrow. This is the wisdom which the Muslims have. The wisdom is proportional to the length of the beard. No. They go on the member and said, we will go to Jannat. Namaz padhiye, Jannat, Jannat. I will turn on us. We must sue them. Had it been in America, we can really sue them. Okay, suppose I am an Indian, but what I hear about suing people here, suppose I just file a complaint, human rights violation against Ali Azhar. Will it be denied? Those who denied Ali Azhar, what are not there, but still, human rights violation, burning the doors of Fatima. What will the Americans say? We must get a chance outside, then we must present this. Anyhow, so we must sue them for using this word Jannat. Why? First of all, that word Jannat does not befit your tongue. Why? Because it does not belong to you. How? You know, isn't it Khandaq? What happened to Khandaq? Amr ibn Abd al-Abdawad came. He was the fellow who used to lift up a small camel and use it as a shield to fight. So, so and so and so and so, all of them were there. This fellow crossed the pit and then challenged. Oh, you the Muslims! I am Umar ibn Abdawad in front of you and I challenge you. Get up and fight. I request you to follow this carefully. None got up and they are talking. My God, look at him. He lifts up a camel and uses it as a shield. Who's going to fight him? All are quiet. As if this is the last breath of theirs. And this fellow here, he roared, oh you the Muslims, what is wrong with you? I am challenging you. Come and fight against me. You believe in this theory, isn't it? Now this is what he put forth. You believe in this theory, isn't it? If you kill me, you are victorious. If I kill you, you go to Jannat. This is what Ali has taught us. Salawat! You kill me, you are victorious, you have won. And if I kill you, Shaheed, you go to Jannat. So, I want you to send you all to Jannat, come out. See this Umar ibn Abdullah. And what did Rasulullah say? Who is he who is going to fight this Kulle Kuf? Complete Kuf. Not partial, not 50%, not 60%, like in Ahad, Badr, Khaybar, not like that. Complete 100% Kuf. 100% 100% kufr is teaching your lesson, which is your Islamic lesson. That is, if you kill me, you are victorious. If I kill you, you go to Jannah. Just like in India, these Hindus are telling us to go and pray. Namaz in Masjid. So what happened? No one gets up. He took his spear and into the tents. He made the hole. Yell! Come out and fight! Why are you so scared of me? I am going to send you to Jannah. Come out! None got up. And if anyone got up, it was Ali ibn Abi Talib. Ya Rasulullah, I am here. I will find this man. Sit, Ya Ali, sit. Again he yelled. Again Ali got up. And the Prophet said, sit. Again he yelled out. Again Ali got up. And except Ali, no one got up. Now Rasulullah said, Barazal Iman. I am sending the complete Iman to fight complete kufr. Now just imagine, 100% Iman against 100% kufr. Now what I want you to note is this. What was he challenging? The concept of Jannah, isn't it? Oh, you the Muslims, you believe in Jannah, isn't it? Come, I want to send you to Jannah, come. So he was challenging the concept of Jannah. And no one believes in it. Had they believed in it, it would have gone. If the challenge, suppose no one got up, the result? And the history would have recorded that there was a person by the name Muhammad ibn Abdullah. He proclaimed himself to be the messenger of Allah. And people did accept his religion. And came the time when during the battle of the Mot, that is Khandaq, Amr ibn Abdawad, a very strong man indeed, he challenged and fell Islam. Isn't it? Except this, what would have history recorded? Tell me. What would have history recorded except this? If Ali had not got up. That means he was not challenging Jannah. He was challenging Islam. He was challenging Muhammad. He was challenging the unity of Allah. He was challenging Quran. So Quran goes, Namaz goes, Roza goes, Hajj goes, Zakat goes, and everything goes, Muhammad goes, Allah goes, everything goes, if Jannat goes. So who saved the Jannat now? Who saved the concept of Jannat? Otherwise, the Tawheed of Allah would have gone. The Nabuwat of Muhammad would have gone. Quran would have gone. Islamic Jurisprudence would have gone. Everything would have gone. Who saved the Nabuwat? Ali. Who saved the Tawheed? Ali. Who saved the Quran? Ali. Who saved the Jannat? Ali. So when Ali saves everyone, will he not save us? Salaam. So concept of Jannat, my friends. Yes, it's being challenged. Why your people did not get up? You know, someone got up and said, there was a need for Rasulullah. Three times, Ali, sit down, sit down, sit down. And the fourth time, the third time, he said, go. Because, you know, what sort of people there? The present politician will take tuition from them. Understand? The present generation until the Qiyamah, all of them will be the students. So, and Rasulullah knew. He said, if I send Ali for the first time, they'll say, we were about to get up. But you know this Rasul, always Ali, always Ali. So he went, and why should we interfere? Had he not said this? And the second time, we were about to get up. We are the followers of Jannah. But again, this Prophet of ours, always his brother Ali, always his brother Ali. Therefore, when he always presents his Ali, as a mark of respect to the Prophet, he kept quiet. Yes. He sent Ali, otherwise he would have offered a knife and killed this man. So Rasulullah cut them. Now you have got no chance to say. And some people there. What are you talking about? These fellows only. Salman was there. Why he didn't get up? Salman was there. Abu Dhar was there. In brief, Salman and co. Abu Dhar and so on and so on. They were there. Why don't you mention their names? Why didn't they get up? Hello, my friend. What makes you take their names? Why didn't you take the names of others? Why are you saying Salman is there, Abu Dhar is there, they also did not get up? Why don't you say so and so was there, so and so was there? Why didn't they get up? So this differentiation between them shows what you are. And we can say Salman would have got up, no doubt. Salman believes. Salman is the dust of the feet of Ali. Therefore, he occupies that position of greatness. Abu Dhar is the dust of the feet of Ali. Therefore, he is so great. We believe in that. They were about to get up. Who? Salman and Abu Dhar and co were about to get up. But when they heard Rasulullah saying, he will be a caliph after me. What did Rasulullah say? Who will go and fight him? He will be the caliph after me. Once they heard that he is going to be a caliph after me, Salman said, that is only for Ali. Abu Dhar said, I cannot get up. That is the right of Ali. Otherwise, we don't value our lives. We fight for the cause. But this is the right of Ali, and except Ali, none will get up. So my friend, what happened? Ali went, and as usual, Ali is what? Always, all-powerful, all-conquering. So, and there, kulla iman, look at the word that Rasulullah used. Has God forbid, just for the sake of argument, Ali lost? Kulla iman gone? Had he not used the word kulla iman, it would have been a different affair. How? Muslims went, Muslims fought, and once in a while, the Muslims lost. That is all the history would have recorded. Had you said Mu'min went, and then Mu'min fought, and once in a while, they lost. The warriors went, the warriors fought, it so happened, they lost. Except this, no danger. But when he said, kulle iman, Ali has kulle kufr, danger. Had Ali lost kulle iman? When kulle iman, he said, there is iman in Islam now. Except nifaq and kufr, nothing would have been pervading. So everywhere, what would have been pervading? Kulle kufr, kulle nifaq. So what prevented kulle nifaq and kulle kufr from pervading throughout the universe? It is Ali ibn Abi Talib. So I appeal to our Muslims brethren, with all respects if they deserve, with all respects which is due to them, that this Jannat which you talk about by leaving the beard and saying your namaz is the right of him. It is my Imam who saved the Jannat.
Oh, yes.
It is not your leaders who saved the Jannat. It is our Mawla who preserved the Jannat. It is not your Khalif who preserved the Jannat. And when the Jannat was preserved by my Mawla, Allah said, this is yours. This is yours. And when it is his, no, tell me, he'll give it to us. Itne muljim, itne ziyad, itne saad, so and so and so and so and so, and go. This is common sense, logical conclusion. So, we can talk about the Jannah from here. Understand? We can talk about the Jannah from the member. It suits us. It suits us. Why? My Mawla saved the Jannah. My Mawla preserved the Jannah. It doesn't suit you to even use the word Jannah because nothing of that, or none of you have done anything for the Jannah. So, my friends, this is what Jannah actually. But I want to close, but it is this. As I told you, in spite of Jannat being ours, you know the hadith, no? Jo roye, ya rulaye, ya rune wale ki surat banaye, Jannat wajib. Those who doubt in this, well, I think they doubt the greatness of Fatima Zahra. If the Jannat does not belong to them, can I put it the other way? Jo zulm karke rulaye, jo zulm karke aur shiddat se rulaye aur takleef de, Jannat belong to them? The tears are those which are the outcome of the expression and the burning of the heart.
Subhanallah.
It is what is in your heart, your eyes shall indicate. When you are happy, your face is all smile. When you hear the fazail of Ali, your face, just if you keep a mirror in front of it, you know what, how nurani it appears. Why? Because you are hearing the zikr of nur. But at the same time, your face changes immediately when we just mention the word Hussain. Hussain's grave is in the heart of the moment. What treasures we have, my friends, what treasures we have. So for us, Jannat, all these are not as important. These are the byproducts of the love of, not love, mawaddat of Ahlul Bayt. Suppose you take some pills, you take some medicine, you have byproducts, no? Like that it is. It will definitely come to us. But for us, everything is de muhabbat, de mawaddat. For us, everything is that except that nothing. We are born with that, we become young with that, we become youth with that, we become of prime age with that, we die with that, we integrate, we mention that name and come up, and on the day of judgment, we get up and say, Ya Hussain, Ya Hussain, Ya Hussain. We are born for this, we live for this, we die for this. This is our way. Nothing can change this way. When the power of Yazid and the power of the South family cannot change, who else can change? This is the miracle, living miracle, the existence of Hussain Zikr. This is the miracle that wherever you go, I challenge you. Last year there was Madras year, isn't it? And suppose I asked you, how was the Madras this year? What do you say? Better than the last. You go to a village throughout the world, irrespective of the place, throughout the world. Compared to last year, how was the Muharram this year? Much better, much better. Why much better? Why much better? better, same matam, same flicker. The person who reads the musibat, can he add and subtract? Same thing, isn't it? Musibat can't change, no, we can't add and subtract. Throughout the world, same thing has been read. Throughout history, till Qiyamah it will be read. The miracle is, every time it is new. This, the Azadari of Hussain is the living miracle of Fatima Zahra. Understand? Azadari of Hussain is the living miracle of Fatima Zahra. When she said, Baba, mere bacche par aansu kaun bahayega? Will you be there? No. Will I be there? No. Will Ali be there? No. Will Hassan be there? No. Then who will weep for my Hussain? One device says, normally what do you hear? Allah will create a home whose youngsters will cry for the youngsters of Hussain, whose ladies will cry for the ladies of Hussain, whose gents will cry for the gents of Hussain, isn't it? But that, there is something added. Allah will create a home whose ladies will cry for the ladies of Hussain, whose children will cry for the children of Hussain, whose gents will cry for the gents of Hussain, and they will consider this matam and crying of your Hussain as the biggest ibadat. Understand? This depends upon your namaz, my brothers. If you catch hold of only namaz, you know what? Shami Ghalima. مکتب میں فتح کے بعدے نماز مغرب کا فضیلت کا وقت عمر سعد کے آرڈرز فضیلت کا وقت ہے نماز پڑھو ادھر اہل بیت اسیر عزت نماز کمن عزت نماز اینڈ ہیئر آن دا نائٹ شام غریباں سید سجاد ون سجاد تھرو آؤٹ دا نائٹ Can you imagine? Without food and water for 3 days, one sajda throughout the night. These are the Ahlul Bayt. We say namaz, we say namaz because we follow them. We think, Maulana has loved to namaz so much, therefore we also read. To please Allah, You please it, Hussain, you are pleasing Allah. مَنْ دَرَفَهُمْ فَقَدَرَفَ اللَّهُ مَنْ جَهِلَهُمْ فَقَدْ اللَّهُ By pleasing Hussain, you are pleasing Allah. So my friends, this is what qazadari is. Now I have been told to read Masail in English, but I can't help it. If that is the wish of the qazadar, here I am. So what happened? The night of Ashura was there. The houses were burnt, the children were yelling, and they went to sleep. No more tents. History records, after the Shahadat of Hussain, these same children who were yelling for water, forgot the word water. They never mentioned the word water. In fact, when the wife of Hur had brought water, a candle was seen, a light. Children had gone to sleep. Zainab taking the place of Abbas, with a stick going round to see that no one comes and attacks the children of Hussain. Suddenly she saw a light coming towards them. Light would come up, glow, go out, glow, go out. Finally came a lady. She was her wife. Zainab asked, who are you? She said, I am the wife of Hur. Immediately Zainab gave her the condolences. Bibi, I Zainab, offer you the condolences of your husband. He came at a time when you could not do anything for him. There was no water available, nor was there any food, so they could not serve anything. Therefore I offer you condolences. This is Zainab. The water came, and then when the water came, it was a small amount, It was taken straight towards the Imam al-Zamana. Who is the Imam al-Zamana now? Sayyidah Sajjad. Zainab was there. Sayyidah Sajjad took some water and offered it to Puppy Zainab. Immediately she started weeping. Beta, you are offering me this water, Beta! Oh, Sayyidah Sajjad! How can I take this water when I saw that Aliyah's bar went without water? Aliyah's bar went without water. My brother Hussain! How can I take this water? She refused to take. At this, Sayyidah Sajjad said, Kupi, oh my aunt Zainab, he made a sign in the atmosphere of Karbala. And what did Zainab see? It was, how is it, Kausar? Rasulullah was being seated. Imam Hassan was there, Hussain was there, Abbas was there, Akbar was there, Azhar was there, Hasim was there, Azhar was in the lap of Fatima Zahra. And Ali ibn Abi Talib, the father, took the water and said, my son Hussain, my son Hussain, this is for you. At first Hussain started weeping and said, Baba, Baba, I do not take the water, Baba. Baba, how can I take water when my sister Zainab, she is still thirsty. How can I take water when my Sakina is thirsty? Zainab saw this, that unless she takes the water, brother will be thirsty. So at once it was brought. A nazar was made. Sayyidah Sajjad said it enough that it was offered to Zainab. Zainab at once went to Sakina. Sakina, oh Sakina, get up Sakina. Sakina, get up. She got up and said, Puppy Amma, what has happened? Sakina, water has come. Has my uncle Abbas come back? Oh my auntie Zainab, has my uncle Abbas come back? No, baby, your uncle has not come back, but this water has come back, water has come. Please take this. Oh, Puppy, I can't take this water. You are more thirsty than me. You take some of this water. But Zainab said, no, the rule is, those who are younger, they take the water first. After that, the elders take it. See, hearing this, at once she took the thunder, went across the mountain, went across the place where Aliyah's girl was lying, and said, oh, Aliyah's girl, oh, my brother Aliyah's girl, the water has come, my brother, come and take water. Hazrakumidallah, and passed the night, and came the 11th morning, and after the 11th morning, as all of you are aware, what happened? Sayyidah Sajjad was made to wear chains, and after all these things, the caravan was told to proceed to Kufa. The caravan was told to proceed to Kufa, and there I would like to relate one incident and close. While they were approaching Kufa, it was a 2 days away from Karbala to Kufa, announcement was being made. All the people of Kufa, this is the announcement from Ibn Ziyad. All the people of Kufa, tomorrow is a declared holiday from the side of the government. All of you have to assemble near the marketplace so that you are going to watch the heads of those who rebelled against Yazid. And you are going to watch those ladies who were the relations of those who rebelled against Yazid. This is the day of enjoyment and you will be rewarded. So all of you, and these are the orders of the government, and I have received these orders from Yazid. You are ordered to get out of the houses to watch. You see? To watch what? To see the head of the grandson of the Prophet? To see what? To see that the ladies of the household of the Prophet with their hairs open? Muslims. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. And came the caravan, the captive's caravan. Imam Sayyidah Sajjad says, the crowd was so huge that it was uncontrollable. And it took a lot of time to even go a few steps further. Because when the crowd made way, the heads would go forward. And when the head would go forward on the spears, the ladies on the caravan, they would proceed. And the heat of Kufa was such that all of them were crying out for thirst. Finally, slowly they proceeded. And the people were so many in numbers that those who could not get away to stand and watch on the roads, they climbed up the houses, the roofs, to watch what? The head of the grandson of the Prophet of Islam. And on one of the roofs stood a lady with four or five of her friends who were from a respectable family. She wanted to say, who these are whose heads have come? And it so happened that the camel on which Zainab was, and on that camel with Zainab was Sakina. So Zainab with Sakina, that camel went and stood near the roof of that lady who was also watching with four or five of her friends. Now, this is clear in your mind. People all around just to watch. The government declared holiday. And what did they see? The heads of the family of the prophets and the ladies of the household of the prophets. On a camel is Zainab with Sakina, and there's a roof. On that roof is sitting a lady with a few of her friends. After some time, Sakina got up and said, Pupi Amma! Looked up. Sakina understood and said, Zainab understood and said, Sakina, do you like to tell me anything? Pupi, oh my aunt, yes, I do like to tell you something. But, she looked down. Zainab clasped her and said, my child, tell me what is it you want. If you don't tell me, is there anyone else whom you will go and tell? Oh my Sakina, oh my child, tell me what is it you want. My aunt, I know there is no one whom I can tell except you. But my aunt Zainab, I find that you are majboor, you cannot do what I want. Zainab said, ask me what is it you want, my child. And the child said, Pupi Amma, Pani, Pani. Zainab at once looked up. Who is asking for water? The granddaughter of Saqi-e-Kawthar. And she's asking whom? The daughter of the Saqi-e-Kawthar. And the daughter of Saqi-e-Kawthar is Majboor. She looked down. Sakina understood. At that point of time, that lady on the roof heard this child wanting water. She cried out and said, Bibi, do not worry. This time she will get water. I'll get the water. She went inside. Immediately she got some tumbler of water and said, Bibi, here is it. Let your child take this water. Zainab took the water, tumbler of water, glass of water, gave it to Sakina and said, Sakina, here is the water. Now what? It is in the hand of Sakina. Zainab is catching it. Suddenly that lady on the roof said, Bibi, who are you? I have not seen such captains like you before in my life. I have seen many captives, and I have seen the caravan of many captives, but I have not seen the captives like you. Bibi, who are you? Bibi, you look something special about it. And Bibi, before the child, after the child takes the water, I have got two requests, and I would like this child to pray for me. Sakina was about to lift the glass of water, then I put a hand. And says, Sakina, stop. First, grant what she wants. Then Abbas, oh lady, what is it you wish for? What is your wish? She said, my first wish is that this child should pray, this orphan should pray, that my Allah bless my children and they should not become an orphan like her. And they should not become a prisoner like her. Hearing this, Zainab took the water from the child, Sakina raised her shirt and said, Malik, O Allah, I give you the master of my orphanhood. I am a yatim. Malik, I give you the master of my yatimi. Malik, never make her children a yatim like me. The lady was happy. And Zainab said, tell me what your second wish is. And the lady said, my second wish is, may Allah give me the guidance and the way to go to the Medina, which is the land of the Prophet. Zainab looked up. Zainab, this is the last riwayat. Zainab looked up and said, Bibi, you want to go to Medina? What is there in Medina that you want to go there? What is there in Medina that you want to visit Medina? To that that lady shouted and said, Bibi, that is the place of all the places in the world. That is the important place of all the important places in the world. And there is Fatima Zahra. Zainab said, Fatima Zahra is no more. She said, yes, I know Fatima Zahra is no more. I know Fatima Zahra is no more. But Sani Zahra is there. I know Fatima Zahra is not no more. But Zainab al-Kubra is there. I know Ali ibn Abi Talib is no more. But I know my Imam Hussein is there. I know that Imam Hussein is there. I know Abbas is there. I know Ali Akbar is there. I know Ali Azhar is there. Hearing this, Zainab understood and said, oh, my Habiba, your prayer has been granted. Oh, my Habiba, you would like to go and meet your Zainab. You would like to go and meet your Hussein. See the head of Hussein on the spear. That is the head of Abbas, that is the head of Ali Akbar, and that is the head of Ali Akbar. Oh, Hamme Habiba, I am the Fatima Zainab. Oh, Hamme Habiba, the house of Fatima is destroyed. Our family is killed, except the head, except all the children, all are no more. And here is Sakina, the 3-year-old child of Hussein, who has been taken taken captive from Karbala to Kufa and Kufa to Sham. Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un. I have a request for you, and that is this. We cry by these tears of ours. We have already bought Jannat. This is our fate of all, isn't it? Well, for this to be preserved, what is the sacrifice offered by Hussein? Hussein gave Abbas. Hussein gave Akbar. Hussein gave Azhar. Hussein gave whatever he had. And then what did he say? Mabood, main aa raha hoon. Mabood, main aa raha hoon. Dunya ke taluqaat tod raha hoon. Mabood, tere aur mere darmiyan kuch nahi. جو رشتے تھے وہ سب ٹوٹ گئے اب تم ہے اور میں ہوں تیرے شان کے خلاف یہ ہے کہ میں بھی نہ ہوں تو بھی رہے بابو میرا سر ہاتھ سے رزن بقضائے ہی و تسلیما لامر انا للہ و انا الیہ راجعون isn't it when Hussein offered that much I appeal to you with folded arms. This is the Imam Bargah of Hussein. And don't you think when Hussein gave Akbar and Asghar and Abbas, it is our duty to see that this is released and we pay off all that is due. And don't think you are paying for nothing, you have been rewarded 700-fold. So my friends, I appeal to you, all the Azadars of the Imam Hussain, with all your might, see, giving nothing is very bad. Giving something is better than giving nothing. So whatever you can, for the sake of Hussain, for the sake of Fatima Zahra, please help us to clear this due. Tadi Farma Zuhur Imam.
Oh, no, say. 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 Say.